she had to do was stop the car. No matter what happened before that, stop the car.
An exotic dancer runs over one of her clients with a car and drags him to his death. Today, she had to face his family and pay the price for her deadly decision.
She's a mother of three, but today she was given the maximum sentence. Good evening to you. I'm Cherie Palello.
I'm Jack Affington. It was a packed courtroom. It was packed with rage. News 5's Karen Johnson joins us live with the testimony and the plea from the victim's family. Karen?
Well, Jack, she said she was sorry. She didn't intend to kill 31-year-old Jay Cho. And back in February, she pleaded guilty to involuntary manslaughter. Well, today, Christina Hensley learned just how long she'll be spending behind bars.
My brother would be here today if all she did was stop. Stop the car like any human being in this room would have done. She kept going for almost a mile and a half. Speeding up, slowing down, swerving, it doesn't matter. There should have been no speeding up, slowing down.
You can hear the anger and sadness in Jun Cho's voice as he spoke of what happened to his brother last August.
My brother went through a mile and a half of the most horrific pain that I can't even imagine.
This is the woman who dragged the 31-year-old to his death. Christina Hensley was a stripper at the time, had been to Jay Cho's Monroe home for a private show. She robbed him, tried to take off. Cho ran after her. She ended up hitting him and dragging him a mile and a half to his death.
She left him there because she's trying to get away from the crime that she had committed. She fled the scene from his house, and she fled my brother that was underneath the car. That is not something that needs to be forgiven.
Despite her tearful apology today in court,
I couldn't ever put into words how very sorry I am for the loss of your son and brother. I can only imagine how you must be feeling. I'm a mother and a sister, and I know I would be devastated beyond words.
Judge Keith Spaeth sentenced her to the maximum for involuntary manslaughter, 10 years in prison. And Judge Spaeth said normally he wouldn't consider the maximum sentence, considering this was her first felony. He says, but given the circumstances in this case, he had no other choice. Reporting live tonight in Hamilton, Karen Johnson, News 5.